Hi. How's it going? Challenger here in the St. Louis radio station of CB and ham and shortwave and scanners and all kinds of crazy stuff happening on the RF frequency range. Broad spectrum of sounds. Had some YouTube viewers mention something a while back. And recently, they asked me about something that they saw when I gave a sweep of the... When I gave a sweep of the station before the makeover, which wasn't much of a makeover, I just was moving some equipment. But they saw something and wanted to see a little more of it. My goodness. So let's see a little more of it. Today we'll just see a little introduction because it is an extensive piece of equipment. And there's much to it. So we'll be later on in life taking the covers off and letting you see the chassis, which is comprised of copper. You never see a copper chassis. When? I mean, even in the most expensive equipment. What is that one? Schwartz and Schroeder? Schroeder and Schwartz? And Watkins Johnson? Oh, yes, Rode. There it is. Rode and Schwartz. Try some of that stuff online. Rode and Schwartz. I believe that's what it is. And Watkins Johnson. Yes, yes, check some of that stuff out. But you don't see none of that copper chassis on any of that stuff. No, no, no. And you never will. And you never did. Because this stuff is unlike any of the other stuff. It's different. This equipment comes from a company called R.L. Drake. And they are the R.L. Drake twins. Check them out for yourself, would you? Of the R.L. Drake twins. And matching power supply for the transmitter. Now we will be getting into these radios a little more deeply in the coming years. As well as looking at the chassis and maybe getting a perfunctory explanation of all the controls and their nomenclature. We'll also be looking at the rear of the equipment so that you may be able to gain an understanding of how it all hooks up with the antenna system as well as with each other. As well as the power supply. But that's what we'll be looking at in the coming decades here on the Challenger radio station. Somebody said they wanted to look at it. Well, there it is. Now, we'll be getting more in depth here shortly. Of course, there is something else. But it is nothing like this, of course. It is one of these things up here. Yes, I was working on these. Working on one of them, actually. Working on that one. That one right there had a busted... front case. The front face plate wouldn't stay on. The tabs that were right here were busted off and would not allow the screws to hold the faceplate on, which was really bad. The scanner worked very well, but the faceplate would just fall right off, and of course, you can't have a scanner where your faceplate's falling off, can you? Of course not. So, of course, my good friend
dude. It's amazing what these good friends will do for you if you just let them do their job. Let them have at it. And because these two little friends here, oh yes, the faceplate no longer comes off. And then it will never come off again. Which is exactly what I wanted. And these right here work very well. They all work very well. Only problem was with this one, the electroluminescent backlighting is no longer, so it's hard to see, but you have to shine a light on it. Which kind of sucks, but hey, what are you going to do? Put it in the shop? I don't think so. It still works. I can look at it, and it shows me what I need to know. This one works real good, but the electroluminescent is on its way out. It's getting dimmer by the minute. And this one, the electroluminescent, or from here to hitherto unknown, it is bright blue. Bright blue. And behind there are several more. Behind the mixer there. But we'll be talking more about them, even though that we did. Yes.
Hi there. So that's what we'll be doing in the coming future. Talking about the R.L. Drake twins. The HF twins. A mighty fine piece of equipment. Or as our UK friends would say, or even Australian or New Zealanders. They all say, I think they say, a great piece of kit. Yes, it is. A wonderful piece of kit, and a wonderful people they are. That's for sure. So, that's what that is about. Do you have any questions before we get into it? Before the future events and future videos about these separate transmitter, the R4A receiver and the T4X transmitter with the matching MS4 power supply and speaker. Oh, yes. The complete kit, mind you. So, with that, we'll say 73. And before I go, I have one of these. Somebody gave it to me. It is a satellite. No, it don't belong up there. If anybody knows where I can get a power supply cheap for this Toshiba satellite in excellent shape, I need a power supply. Anybody know something, let me know. Give me some email at dino911@charter.net. dino911@charter.net. If you know where I can get a power supply cheap for this Toshiba satellite. I thank you for all your help and for watching my little videos here in St. Louis while we go through the transitions of various nomenclature. With that, 73, and I'm completely out of my mind.